Hey everyone, I just stumbled across WokWi. It's an online Arduino and ESP32 simulator. They've got a bunch of examples on their homepage, but let's try some ESP32 right after this quick word from the channel sponsor, PCBWay. Do you like PCBs? Do you want to make a PCB in a weird and wacky colour like purple? Maybe you'd like a flexible PCB. Or maybe you'd like someone to do some CNC work for you. Check out the link to PCBWay in the description. So let's create an ESP32 sketch. We'll do the classic blink. So the first thing we'll need is an LED. We'll wire this up with the anode connected to a GPIO pin and the cathode connected to ground. Now in the code, we just need to set the pin to output and then in our loop, we'll set it to high, have a half second delay, and then set it to low, and then follow that with another half second delay. And now we can just hit the simulate button and it will start to flash our LED. It works amazingly well. So that's a simple blink sketch. You can also pull in Arduino libraries. Here we have a tiny Pico board and we're pulling in the tiny Pico helper library, and we're going to cycle the colours on the dot star LED. So here's all the code, and then we just hit simulate. And it works. It works really nicely. We're now running a tiny Pico and running the dot star LED. There's also more complex examples. So here's a 7-segment display. So we're using the SevSeg library. And then we hit simulate. And it updates the 7-segment display. There's also built-in support for Wi-Fi, so here's a sketch that will scan for Wi-Fi networks. And it will print out all the details about the Wi-Fi network it's found. So there's a built-in network in the simulation system, so if we run this sketch, it will start up. And now we've initialized the Wi-Fi and we're scanning. And it's found the guest network on the WokWi. So you can connect to this and use the internet from your ESP32. Not only that, you can also do this in Python. So here's the same code but running in Python. So if we run this, we'll see it starts the Python interactive environment. And it's run and it scanned the network. I'm going to even run bits of Python code here so we can print hello world. So here's some more Python examples. This is running a Neopixel example. So we import the Neopixel and then when we run it, it cycles through the Neopixel colors. There's also quite an interesting thing you can do. So here I'm running in PlatformIO and I'm building the blink sketch and compiling it on my computer. So I'll compile the firmware. And now if we go back to WokWi, I can hit F1 and I can load in my firmware and run it on the simulator. So we select our bin file and now our blink sketch is running. And you can see it's running my code because we can see the serial writes writing blink, which is what I have in my code. So that's pretty amazing. We built the firmware on my machine and now we're running it on the simulator. Now, of course, there are some limitations. So we don't have I2S, SPI, PWM, DMA or Bluetooth. There's no hardware acceleration. But apart from that, it works amazingly well and it seems like a really good way of testing your firmware. So if you've used this before, please let me know in the comments what your experience was and how well it worked for you. I'd never seen it before, so I was quite surprised to come across it. If you'd known about it for a while, then why didn't you tell me? Because I'd have loved to hear about it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.